Hi, it's Ryan Mooney here from Ryan Mooney Fishing, helping you fish smarter, not harder. Today we're going to have a little discussion about cast nets. About 12 months ago, we done a YouTube video on how to throw a cast net off the wrist. It's a way I've been using for about 25, 26 years. But it went viral over YouTube and the internet, and we've had a lot of questions, and some of them are about what sort of cast nets can you get and what applications are they meant for. So that's what we're going to touch on today. Some of the different cast nets to use and where you should be using them. Okay, the first cast net we're going to show you is your standard bottom pocket cast net. This is the most common one you'll find around the place and which is used by most people. Now, they're pretty versatile. You can use them, they're mostly meant for shallow water, but you can still use them in waters sort of 2 meters deep to chase herring if you want to, if you don't want to have to go to a different kind of net. They're pretty simple. At the top, just a sealed off funnel attached to a swivel. That's so nothing can get out the top there, it's all sealed. And down the bottom here, you'll notice that it is all pockets sewn in there. They lift the lead line up and they take it inside the net and they sew it up a little bit higher. And what that does is creates a pocket right through the bottom of the net. And what happens is when you pull it in, you hold the rope down low and all the bait fish will end up sliding down the net and getting stuck in these pockets. So that's your standard bottom pocket cast net. Great for around gutters for chasing prawns and mullet and whiting, garfish, all that sort of thing, off the beaches in the shallows. Now the type of cast net we use in deep water for herring and those sort of critters that like to get around deep water structure, off jetties, around snags and deep bends in the creeks, that sort of thing, we mostly like to use what's called a drawstring cast net. Now what it basically is, the top of the net is an open funnel. And what it does, it has 12 strands of monofilament that come down through the net and they go right down and they attach at equal locations all around the lead line. And there's no pocket in the bottom of this net. It becomes a whole pocket in itself. So you've got all these monofilament strands coming down, attaching themselves sporadically around the net in equal places. And when you throw it, the line pulls up the center and that falls down and becomes a great big pocket in itself. So it's nice and easy when you get it back into the boat, you lift your line back up through the center of the net and everything just falls straight out the bottom of the pockets. You can dump them straight into your live bait tank or a bucket or a bin of some sort and drop them in your tank and off you go fishing. Very clean and easy way of catching bait and probably one of the most popular nets on the market these days. And the nets we are using are the Jarvis Walker series and they're a great production net, very well priced, very cheap, and pretty good value for money, that's for sure. I like using them because, you know, custom nets cost upward of around about $250, and one of these you can get for about $80 to $90, and they pretty much last just as long, so that's why I just use a good production net these days. Okay, the third most common kind of cast net is what's called a top pocket net. Now basically, what they're meant for is mostly prawning, or for all the critters that like to shoot up to the top of the net, and that's the most common thing the prawns do. So as what we've got here is a normal standard bottom pocket cast net. It's got pockets in the bottom as well. Now it comes up, and the existing funnel comes to about here, and you can see it there. That's the funnel that's open right up, and it's not sealed at the top. It's actually open. That entire net funnel is open, and what they do is they sew another piece on down here, another piece comes right up to the top here and it's just like a huge pocket in the top of the net and it's not sealed, it's open. You can open it up like so as well. That's for dumping your bait out. And what happens is when the prawns flick up the top of the net, they go through this funnel here which is held up by a few strands and so it's held in place and they all fall out and get stuck all in the top pocket here. They can't go back down the net and they can't get out the top because that's sealed. Okay, now say you've got a whole heap of bait stuck in the top pocket here. What you do is, there's a little slider down here that falls down to hold all that shut. Lift that slider up, and that whole top pocket opens up. So what you can do then, is you turn your net upside down, and everything just falls straight out that top pocket. Close it back up, pull that little locking slider back down, and you are ready to cast again. One more thing to discuss is the size of the cast net. Now, if you're a small person or a young fella just getting into it, a 6 to 7 foot drop cast net is perfect. If you're a really tall person and rather physical, up to 10 footer, great. You can cover more area, catch a bit more bait. Personally, for me, I like to use a 9 foot drop. It suits me fine, and I can catch just enough bait in a short period of time, so I'm not spending all day worrying about catching bait. I like to use the 1 inch mesh size. There is a 3/4 size, which is a bit, I find a bit small. So 1 inch is the best. The 3/4 seems to catch a lot of rubbish and clogs your net up and juvenile fish you don't really need. Just make sure you check the regulations from your local area, because size restrictions do vary around the country and the world, and in some places you can't use them. Now also, if you want to check out my nice, easy, safe way of throwing the cast net, there'll be a link on here somewhere that'll take you over to there. If you enjoyed this little tip and you'd like to see more, subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, or if you want some special tips that I only send out via email, head on over to our website www.ryanmoodyfishing.com and sign up to join our free fishing community. Keep fishing smarter, and I'll see you next time.